experiencia que tuvimos en el Homestead Miami Speedway con Ferrari Norteamérica, fuimos después, digamos, viajamos al centro de Miami, a Brickell, para estar con Toyota en la presentación regional del nuevo Corolla 2014. Y aunque ya aquí en este show hemos hablado algunas veces del Corolla 2014 que fue presentado inicialmente allá en Santa Mónica, en California, hace un par de meses, la Toyota está haciendo un tour por todo el país presentando este nuevo modelo, que sin duda es uno de los de más venta acá en Estados Unidos después del Camry. El Corolla esperan vender más de 300.000 unidades del Toyota Corolla en el 2014, así que si va un poco más rápido de esa cifra, son cerca de 1.000 autos todos los días, una cosa increíble. Y además el Toyota Corolla 2014 se fabrica acá ahora en Estados Unidos, así que vamos a hablar con Jim Cullen de Toyota Communications para hablar del Toyota Corolla 2014.
Jim, thank you very much for coming to Miami for a change. For me, I always go around the country to LA a lot, where Toyota is. But now you're here in Miami doing a regional event for the new Corolla.
Yeah, we're here for the regional Corolla press events.
Yeah,
and it's really exciting to be here in Miami. It's important for us.
Yeah, Miami is a special operation for you guys, because it's a very important market, but it's kind of its own operation right here, right?
I understand. Yeah, our cars here are sold by our private distributor, Southeast Toyota. So. We have a unique partnership with them, and they do a terrific job for us.
Yeah, one of the most important markets. I believe that the biggest dealership is still in LA, right? Longo.
Longo, and I think there's another dealership right here that's always been one of the top
dealerships. Kendall Toyota.
Kendall Toyota has been one of the top dealerships in the country.
And this car obviously is very, very important for you guys. I mean, it's one of the most sold cars in the world, period. I mean, so it's not only important for Toyota.
Yeah.
So. The car is already on sale, and I guess it's doing really well. I mean, even from like the figures that you just shared with us today, I mean, you expect to sell over 300,000 cars in a year. That's almost 1,000 cars every day.
We're going to sell, you know, I mean, the industry is doing well right now. So
absolutely.
I think 300,000 is going to be a pretty solid target for us by the end of the year. Next year, we think the Corolla will sell almost 330,000 cars. So we've probably got a pretty aggressive sales plan.
Yeah, and the car supports it, because, I mean, the car is fabulous. It's very, very different from the previous generation. This is the 11th generation, right?
Absolutely.
And this looks much more modern, as you were saying before. The whole industry is going that way. People want more for less, and you're giving a lot for this kind of car.
Well, I think the expectations for the consumer have changed. There is a expectation on styling. There's an expectation on performance. There's an expectation on what they consider the features that they want in the automobile. And customers are, you know, they don't move off of those expectations. So
they want more.
They only want more. So you have to do your best to put together what I think we've done with Corolla is a pretty solid package that we think is going to attract a wide range of buyers.
Yeah, both your design and engineering teams have done a fabulous job. But how challenging is that? Because, I mean, technology has allowed to like lower prices and some things, but I mean, obviously it's talent behind, it's people, right? Like who make the decisions, like how it's the car gonna look, what content is gonna have on it. But it's still very challenging, because the competition, even though you're number one probably in this segment, but it's still pretty pretty competitive segment.
A very competitive segment. Now, we were not number one in this segment. We were the number two selling car with a vehicle that we had introduced back in 2008.
Yeah.
So. I think our aspirations are to for a leadership role in the segment, but you just talked about the styling and the value of the vehicle. I think all of those elements make a great package in this automobile, and I just think that younger buyers in particular are going to look at this car and go, okay, that's something that I'm interested in driving. That's something that I want, rather than something
I want to be looking at.
Yeah, absolutely.
Right?
Yeah.
Yeah, because before, I mean, to be completely honest, the Corolla was like an entry level car for a lot of people.
Yeah.
And now, as you said, like the design is completely different. I mean, some people probably don't even recognize it as a Corolla, which is a good thing in this case.
That may be a very good thing, but I think when you look at the car and you look at some of the colors and some of the features and the technology that's in the car, it makes a really, really solid package. And I think customers are going to recognize that immediately.
Yeah. So the most you can spend on this car is around 20,000, right? But
yeah.
That's like completely loaded.
Yeah. So it starts at $16,800. So, I think we cover a broad spectrum in that subcompact market that is going to be a very attractive, and people are going to realize how much they're getting for their money.
Excellent. Well, thank you very much again for having us here in Miami and for coming here. You should come more often.
I certainly should, especially if we can spend an evening like I think we're going to spend tonight.
Yeah, though, fortunately, this is radio where people are not looking around. It's like a beautiful place here in Miami. So thank you very much again.
Okay, thank you.
Esa fue la entrevista que tuvimos con Jim Colom del equipo de comunicaciones de Toyota hablando sobre el Corolla 2014. Que terminó su tour de presentación nacional en Estados Unidos en Miami y donde se anunció que ahora el Toyota Corolla será fabricado y exportado desde Estados Unidos a 18 mercados de América Latina. Y cuando regresemos aquí en Auto 060 vamos a otra experiencia en el Homestead Miami Speedway, esta vez con la Nismo Performance Academy. No se vayan, esto es Auto 060, yo soy Javier Mota.